Hey guys, it's me, Tommy, and I'm back again with another video. In this video, I'll be showing you how I created these beautiful faux locs using the rubber band method. I know you're interested, and I'm gonna show you how to do it. Let's jump right into it. So Sam's Beauty sent me over about 6 to 7 packs, I don't remember how many, of these Havana Mambo twists in the color M430. I love this color, it's so beautiful. And then as my base, I'm gonna be using some Marley hair, just your typical Marley hair. It doesn't matter what texture or anything like that, it's just my base. So we're gonna always start off with freshly washed hair, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna divide my hair into sections. I always section the front off first and then work on the back, because as you can see, my hair is so thick. So on the back row, I'm gonna show you guys just an example of how I'm gonna do the rubber band method. I'm gonna moisturize my hair, use some jam to slick down the roots of my hair, and then I'm just gonna add rubber bands to my hair. I'm using the clear rubber bands because I feel like it doesn't give you that much pulling and tugging to your hair, and I think it would be just more of a healthier method. I discovered that with the Brilliant Beauty, Jodi Ann. I saw her do that in one of her rubber band method videos with her box braids, and I'm like, sounds like a good idea, so I'll give that a shot. Next, what I'm going to do is, after I finish making my sections, I'm just gonna twist my hair off so it's better for me to see each section when I am going to add the locks to my hair. Being that I'm doing it myself and I'm just using two mirrors to see what I'm doing, this is just the easier way for me to see with my hair not in the way. So this is the completed look as my base. I have 52 locks in my hair, in case you guys are asking. So let's just jump right into it. So in order for me to do the rubber band method, basically you just need to take some Marley hair. I'm gonna take 2 pieces of the Marley hair, because you know they come individually wrapped, not individually wrapped, but sectioned. And I'm just gonna braid my twists with the Marley hair. I just want a solid base. Then I'm going to unravel the Mambo twist, and I'm gonna use that to wrap my locks around. I'm gonna spread the locks, not the locks, the twists out so that they're nice and flat, and then I'm gonna go ahead and crochet one side into the rubber band. So I'm gonna stick the crochet underneath the rubber band. I'm going to catch that hair into the crochet. I'm gonna pull it through, and then I'm gonna start wrapping. I saw some methods like this on YouTube, and I decided to just give it a shot as well. And I really like this method because it literally, like, my locks were not tight. They didn't feel heavy at all, and it was very simple for me to do. I had a nice base, and it cut the time down a little bit. My locks are pretty long, so it was still a little bit long to do, but it did cut the time down just by a few hours. So I'm gonna lay the hair flat, and I'm just gonna keep wrapping around the Marley base that I have. Now, the color that I'm using, the M430, was actually inspired by Teaira Walker when she had faux locs in her hair. I loved that color on her. So I decided to try that color, and I couldn't find anything that was close to it, and I thought this was the closest thing to it, even though it's not Marley hair, which you can use for faux locs. So I'm using twisting hair. So it wasn't as, it wasn't really staying too much. I'm just gonna be honest with you. So I would suggest using a different type of hair. It did unravel a little bit, so I had to burn the ends to keep it from unraveling. But I do love this color, it's very, very pretty. So I'm just showing you the method again by just inserting that braiding hair, Marley hair, whatever hair you wanna wrap around for your locks. You just push it underneath your rubber band, you're gonna crochet it, and you're just gonna wrap around. Look at how lightweight it is. I'm able to move it around. There's literally no tension with my head. I love it so, so much. And don't worry guys, I'm gonna show you guys how it looks with wrapping it on the bottom, just showing you how that section looks. So I'm gonna show you again wrapping around. In this clip I was done, but one of the locks came out, so I have to rewrap it, and now I get to show you how it looks at the end. So since the hair is a little bit chunky, I wrap it down and then I split the Marley hair, or whatever hair it is that you have as your wrapping hair. I split it in half to make it a little bit thinner. I'm gonna go down, and then when I feel like I'm ready to go up, I'm gonna just wrap it back up. And that's just how you seal the ends. You just keep wrapping it until you can't wrap it no more, and then you just cut off the excess hair. And that's just basically how you seal it on the bottom. I have a little bit sticking out, so I'm just gonna cut that as well. And that's basically it, guys. I think it's pretty simple. If you don't know how to braid, this is a great method for you. You can just twist that Marley hair underneath instead of braiding it. I like the way it curls up a little bit, gives it a little funky look. It's so, so lightweight, guys. Like, you don't understand. Like, I can literally just throw it up in a ponytail and it's not hurting me. And this is the same night. I got these little rings from the beauty supply store, so I'm just showing you guys how you can insert it. If it's too tight, just put some scissors inside and open it up and stick it in your locks for more island vibe to it. The way I positioned my little clamps in my hair, you didn't really see it that much, but they're really, really pretty. I got them for like $1 in my beauty supply store. And that's just to jazz it up a little bit. And that's basically the tutorial, guys. It's really simple to do. You're basically just gonna twist some Marley hair over your twist and then wrap it around with the crochet braids. As you can see, I had one of the Marley twists in my hair. I didn't realize I missed a section. And then just style it and go. If you have any questions, guys, you can leave it below, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.